In the world of science and technology, we're always looking forward, forecasting what's to come, and predicting what life might be like for the next generation. But now, more than ever before, we're at an intriguing and potentially pivotal moment, because the next generation might also be the first generation with total biological control. This is Unveiled, and today we're taking a closer look at the extraordinary claim that humans will be able to regenerate by 2050. Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content. The idea of regeneration is popular in science fiction, and perhaps it most famously features in the long-running BBC time travel saga, Doctor Who. In the show, the central character is able to fully rebirth themselves into another physical body, and thereby continue to live, much to the Daleks' dismay. But up until recent times, that regenerative power might have felt much more like magic than anything that could actually happen in real life. Today, however, the gift of the Doctor is upon us. Neil deGrasse Tyson is one of the most well-known voices in modern popular science, and while he's probably best known for his various musings on astronomy and the state of the universe, in late 2022, he made headlines with some bold predictions about the future of the human body. Appearing on various TV shows, including Piers Morgan Uncensored, to promote his latest book, Starry Messenger: Cosmic Perspectives on Civilization, deGrasse Tyson prophesies that by the year 2050, humans will be able to regenerate limbs and organs. In his book, he also suggests that we'll have a cancer cure by 2050, much improved antivirals perhaps to the point of perfection, and maybe even a cure for mental illness. Regarding regeneration, however, deGrasse Tyson broadly argues that if it's possible for other animals, which it is, then it should be possible for humans too. Speaking to Piers Morgan, he highlights how a newt already has some regenerative powers, with the suggestion being that, should we choose to, we might one day mimic the newt and obtain similar skills ourselves. It would hardly be the first time that human beings will have looked to nature for inspiration on what to do next. Everything from the power of flight, to a variety of textiles, to the development of AI has in some way been influenced by nature before. For deGrasse Tyson then, the regrowth of limbs is something that we could, and probably will, add to our ever-growing arsenal of life improvements. But how far might this idea be taken? There's little doubt that being able to regrow limbs could be an exciting option for those that need it. In the 21st century, the development of prosthetic limbs has seen some big improvements, with the addition of AI and BCIs, brain control interfaces, promising an ever more comfortable and even seamless experience. And of course, to some degree, artificially replacing some organs is already possible too. But straight up regeneration, if it works, would trump all of that. In his interviews, deGrasse Tyson doesn't go into major details as to how it would all work, but it's clear that if it were possible, then such knowledge could be used for things other than entire limb or organ growth as well. Smaller injuries might be much easier to treat, for example, with even regular cuts healing much quicker thanks to this newfound ability to manipulate our own biology. This could lead to far fewer infections on a smaller scale too. Presumably, in this hypothetical future, all parts of our bodies would be possible for us, meaning muscle, bone, skin, nerve endings, and so on. But if so, then would we necessarily wait until a limb was lost completely before we regrew it? Could we actually modify ourselves prior to that stage? Could we, say, manage arthritis in a similar way, joint pain, or muscle wastage? If regrowing whole parts of ourselves were possible, then would it also be possible to tackle problems in those body parts as well? Overall then, deGrasse Tyson's vision imagines more than just a spectacular superpower that we might one day possess. It suggests that within the next 30 years or so, health and medicine may have passed through another full-scale revolution. While there are various procedures that do already make use of organic human material, such as organ transplants, blood transfusion, and skin grafts, this would take those principles down an all-new direction. Typically, when predictions are made toward us modifying our bodies in the future, the focus is wholly on artificial solutions. Strengthened skeletons for super strength, high-tech lenses for improved visions, tiny audio chips for heightened hearing, or mechanical upgrades to allow our hearts to beat better for longer. But here, with regeneration, it could be that there's much less of a reliance upon machines, and much more of a trust in our own bodies. Again, the natural world offers various examples of creatures that can already do this. As well as newts, there are starfish, some lizards, including geckos and chameleons, and salamanders, including axolotls. Elsewhere, deer continually regrow their antlers, and sharks continually regrow their teeth. None of those require any kind of AI or artificial add-on to work. It's not clear exactly how we would harness such abilities and transfer them to ourselves, however. But it is true that we've never before had a better grasp of our own biological makeup. Modern science knows our DNA in extreme detail, while developments like CRISPR-Cas9 mean that we can literally cut and change our genes. Consider then what human regeneration could mean for aging. The diminishment of the cells that make us us has always seemed like an immovable fact of life. But if we could regrow whole limbs, then would we also be able to revitalize our entire bodies against that slow decline? Could the same or similar techniques be used to stop us getting old? Importantly, deGrasse Tyson himself doesn't go so far as to proclaim that that's what will happen. But his comments do stoke the ongoing debate of immortality. Is it possible? When will it be possible? And what will happen after we've achieved it and beaten death forever? Here's where the power to regenerate may, in the long run, cause some logistical, legal, and ethical headaches. First, would regeneration be possible for everyone? Or just for some? If the latter, then how would the split between those who can do it and those who can't be formed? Would regeneration be used only in hospitals, and only after a professional diagnosis? Or could it become a more cosmetic venture? If so, would it only be available to the very rich? But before that, who would it be tested on to ensure that it works? What do you think will happen? Despite regeneration already existing in the natural world, there could be many failed experiments between now and its future use with humans. But equally, if it is possible, and it's implemented well, then it could become a truly breakthrough moment in our story. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments. Check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.